There are three CAN error states: error active, error passive, and bus off. Let's look into each one of them in detail. We have looked into a couple of important concepts in the last videos, and in this video, we will wrap it all up with last few important concepts. Let's get back to error handling in CAN network. We have talked about different types of error already in last video. If you haven't watched it yet, I highly recommend you to watch it before you go through this video. So in this video, let's look into CAN node error states and what are different error flags that a CAN ECU, also called as CAN node, can raise in the network. Every CAN controller in the CAN bus tries to detect error within a message, as error handling is built into the CAN protocol. If the node finds an error, the discovering node transmits something called as error flag and error delimiter, which constitute the error frame, thus destroying the bus traffic. Here the CAN node uses specific error counter to detect fault and perform error confinement. There are three CAN error states: error active, error passive, and bus off. Let's look into each one of them in detail. Error active. Error active state is activated in a node when transmit error counter is less than 127 and receive error counter is less than 127. That is, if the node identifies at least few transmit or few receive error, it will send out active error flag indicating other ECU in turn that there seems to be some error in the message transmitted or received. In this state, the error detected ECU will send error flag containing 6 dominant bits followed by 8 receive delimiter bits. Now the error frame that appears in the network can range from 14 to 20 bits, with 6 to 12 bits of error flag and 8 bits of error delimiter. You might wonder, how is that possible when error detecting node is sending 6 bits of error flag and that the network is containing 6 to 12 bits of error flag? Let's get a deeper understanding on what's happening in the network. So in the network, it's not just the first ECU which detects the error that sends the error flag, but also other ECUs that detects the error flag also sends across the error flag again. Meaning, all the ECUs in the network will send the error flag for the same error at some point of time. So depending on the time when other ECU gets to know the error flags will be extended accordingly. Let's look at each scenario that could happen in the CAN network. Consider an error that gets detected by all the nodes at the same time. Then the CAN bus will contain only 6 dominant bit error flag and 8 receive bit error delimiter. Let's look at another scenario where there is a bit error which is detected by the transmitter ECU of the message. In this case, the error is only detected by transmitter ECU. So here, all the other ECUs will only respond to the error flag after all the 6 error flag bits from the transmitter ECU are transmitted in the network. In the sense, all the other ECUs will consider it as bit stuff error, observing the error flag and send across their error flag simultaneously. Hence, in this case, first the transmitter ECU will send the error flag, and then after all the 6 dominant bits are sent, other ECUs will send the error flag of the dominant bits again. And in total, the error flag will be of 12 dominant bits, followed by 8 error delimiter receive bits. There can also be condition where ECUs in the network identify the bit stuff error before 6 dominant bits of error flag from the transmitted ECU are sent. So in this case, the error flag will be less than 12 bits, followed by 8 error delimiter receive bits. So let's get back to the error states. So let's look into the error passive state here. Error passive state is activated in a node when transmit error counter is greater than 128 or receive error counter is greater than 128, but both are still less than 255. That is, if the node identifies quite some amount of transmit or receive error, it will send out passive error flag indicating other issues in turn that there seems to be some error in the network. But this time, it could also mean that there is some error in the detected ECU as well. So in this state, the error flag that appears in the network is of 6 error flag bits of receive value, followed by 8 bits of error delimiter, which is of receive bits again. Since the error flags are receive, the effect of these error flags are minimal on the message transmitted on the network, as the error flag gets overwritten by transmitted message. For example, if the message transmitted in the network looks like this, and let's assume CAN node A sends a passive error flag, then as you can see, the actual message reflected on the network will be in sync with the transmitted message and not the error flag. Let's consider a scenario where transmitter is sending the passive error flag. This will correspond to a consecutive sequence of 6 recessive bits. This in turn will be detected as a bit stuffing error by all CAN nodes. Hence, these nodes will raise active error flag of 6 dominant bits. In other words, a passive transmitter can still communicate that a CAN frame is erroneous. Going back, let's now look into the last error state of the node, the bus off state. In the bus off state, the CAN node disconnects itself from the CAN bus and can no longer transmit data or raise error flag. In this state, the ECU is not responsive to message sent on bus for some amount of time. The general rule of thumb is that the node shall wait for 128 occurrence of 11 consecutive receive bit in the network to recover back from bus off. And this rule was established considering the robustness of the network. Following occurrence can be considered for recovery. Data frame with 11 bits, which accounts for 1 bit of acknowledgement delimiter, 7 bits of end of frame, 3 bits of IFS, or error frame, which accounts for 11 bits containing 8 bits of error delimiter and 3 bits of IFS. In the essence, you have to wait for 128 occurrence of successful data frame or error frame, or simply 128 occurrence of 11 consecutive receive bits. Best case scenario would be when the bus is idle, as in this case, the bus will be in receive state. Assuming that the baud rate is 1 Mbps of the network, then you will need in total 1408 microseconds. So with this, we have covered the CAN error states and error flag.